Hey, welcome to the troubleshooting portion of this learning path. If you're here, you've either reached the end of the training, congratulations, or you jumped here directly because you got stuck somewhere along the way. If that's the case, let's go through the possible roadblocks in order. If you couldn't install Enscape in the first place, maybe because the .exe file type seems unfamiliar, it's likely you're currently working on a Mac. Enscape unfortunately doesn't support iOS at this point. If you're running into this issue, please first of all check our system requirements, which are linked in the description. If your Mac contains an AMD graphics card that meets our system requirements, you can use Bootcamp to install Windows and run Enscape on it. Parallels is sadly not supported. If you installed Enscape but can't find it afterwards, be aware that Enscape is a plugin, so it won't show up on your desktop. You will only find it in your design application interface. If you can't find it here, please refer to the Do I Have the Right CAD lesson in this playlist and the Installing Enscape lesson. If you're running into troubles when opening Enscape, there is most likely one of four reasons for that. Either your graphics card driver is out of date. If you've made sure to update your graphics card driver beforehand, as described in the corresponding video in this playlist, this should be ruled out. If not, please proceed to do so and test again. Secondly, maybe your graphics card is incompatible. Please make sure you've checked your computer hardware as described in the Do I Meet the System Requirements lesson. If you have a compatible graphics card from AMD or Nvidia, but it's crashing nonetheless, or even telling you Enscape is using the graphics card from Intel, please refer to the knowledge base article Multi-GPU Issues, which is linked in the description. If all these points are verified, but Enscape still crashes during startup or loads indefinitely, it's possible that your model is big or complex enough so your hardware runs into issues. This should be a rare case, so please make sure to check by loading another small sample project or even an entirely empty project. If this loads just fine, you might want to try reducing the complexity of the project you want to visualize. Here, it's worth noting that the part that has the biggest impact on the VRAM on your graphics card are texture files. Try to go with 2K resolution for the textures and you should be fine. Or try cutting the project into portions using section cuts to reduce the size of your visualization. Okay, let's move on. What can we do if Enscape opens but your project is shown incorrectly? If you don't see your project at all, it's likely the camera is just positioned somewhere it's not in view. Try hitting the number keys on your numpad, 2 or 5, and the camera should be positioned with the entire project in view right away. Alternatively, open the view management, pressing the F key in the Enscape interface. Here is where you can see all the views from your design application. It's also worth noting that Enscape will take the view settings from the selected view or scene. This means if certain parts of the project don't show up or some visibility changes are not applied in Enscape, it's always useful to check if you are in the right view or scene in Enscape at the moment. If your materials don't show up correctly in Enscape, be aware that Enscape uses the Appearance tab to render its materials from Revit by default. Make sure you are making all of your edits to the materials in the Appearance tab. If you've edited the Appearance tab but your materials still show up just in plain colors, please check if this setting is set to Appearance, General Settings, Revit, Material Selection. Also, please be aware that Enscape doesn't support procedural textures selected in Revit. Any texture you want to apply has to be an image file. If you experience crashes while trying to render an image or video, this again indicates that maybe the scene is too complex to fit on your graphics card. To tackle this, first, please make sure your graphics card drivers are up to date. Reduce the resolution down to full HD and the rendering quality to high, or even lower, just to check if this resolves the issue. If yes, we know it has to do with the resolution, complexity and scale of your outputs. If your GPU is not an RTX card, try disabling the RTX option found in the General Settings, Performance options. Also, try cutting the model using section cuts to reduce the workload. It also could be worth reviewing the textures in the project to see if these can be reduced or optimized in any way. Again, a 2K texture resolution is perfectly sufficient in almost all cases. Lastly, Rebooting the machine before using Enscape will clear the VRAM, freeing up resources for Enscape on the GPU.
We are confident that through this onboarding training, along with the self-help available via the knowledge base, you should have the materials available to enable you to continue work without a time delay. However, should you need support, please feel free to reach out to us via the feedback button or via our web contact form on enscape3d.com. To help us solving your problem, please make sure to have the Include log files into feedback option enabled. Also, please leave us a description of what exactly happened and what you did before the issue occurred. Lastly, please make sure your email address is entered correctly so you'll receive a response to the right address.